Blackstone Audio presents Hornswoggled, an Alafair Tucker mystery by Donis Casey. This book is dedicated to two pillars of the house, my mother-in-law, Mabel Couser, whom I never knew, and my sister, Carol DeWelt, who lived it with me. Her children arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. Proverbs 31:28. Acknowledgments. Many thanks to all the people at Poisoned Pen Press, Geetha and Jessica, the incomparable Monty, and my friend Nan, who traveled with me hand in hand. And, of course, a deep bow of gratitude to Robert Rosenwald and Barbara Peters, without whom none of this would have happened. You know you have a good editor when her suggestions make you slap your forehead and exclaim, "What was I thinking?" So many people contributed to and helped me with my research that I can't possibly name them all here. But it would be remiss of me not to mention Rebecca Burke, who gave me her grandmother's bumblebee song, and my cousin Don Wagner for the fascinating background on the old wire road that passed through Lone Elm, Arkansas. My childish feet trod that ground 100 times, yet little did I know. Special thanks to Carolyn Hart, master author, for her warm-hearted generosity and guidance to the lively Oklahoma literary scene. Don't be modest now. I'd have been lost in my own country without you. As always, my love and thanks to my beloved family and friends, my bedrock support crew, and to Max, who stands alone. Chapter 1. Something bad was bound to happen. It was just that kind of hot, humid Oklahoma July day, with a gritty wind that blew everything awry. 15-year-old George Washington Tucker, known as G-Dub, hunkered on the grassy, overgrown banks of Cane Creek, grimly hanging onto his fishing pole, trying to ignore the sweltering heat and the clouds of gnats, mosquitoes, and various other disgusting critters who were trying to fly up his nose and into his eyes and drink the salt off of his sweat-slick skin. The hot wind was maddening, the way it blew first out of the north, then out of the southwest, then died and dropped his damp black curls into his eyes. At least when it picked up again, it blew the gnats away for a few seconds. And it wasn't even quite noon. That was the sad thing. Normally, G-Dub loved fishing, since he was a contemplative boy. He loved thinking about what his mother was going to do with a little perch or crappie or occasional catfish that he would catch. Oh, how good they would taste. Rolled in cornmeal and fried quickly in bacon grease until the tender white flesh was encased in a golden crust. Having to eat the fish slowly, so slowly, and chew so carefully to avoid swallowing one of the hundreds of tiny bones only enhanced the dining experience. But today, the joy of fishing was ruined not just by the worrisome weather, but by G-Dub's 11-year-old brother Charlie, and Charlie's ever-present canine companion, Charlie Dog. Charlie Boy had insisted on going swimming. G-Dub had sent him and his dog as far downstream as he could and still keep an eye on them, but it was no good. All his splashing and jumping and hollering had spooked the fish, and there would be no fried fish for dinner. G-Dub was bereft. He could hear Charlie yelling at him, "Look at me, G! Look at me!" But G-Dub didn't look. He didn't want to encourage the boy. Charlie was climbing up into a young cottonwood, crawling out onto a wayward branch that hung over the creek, and dropping himself off into the middle of the water with a whoop. He must have done it 10 times, with the dog running up and down, barking the whole time, and G-Dub had just about had enough. The weather was getting hotter, the fishing was bad, and Charlie was driving him right round the bend. He pulled in his line. Suddenly there was a crack of noise as loud as a rifle shot and a splash, and G-Dub leaped where he sat. He looked downstream wide-eyed. Charlie was nowhere to be seen. The yellow shepherd was leaping and barking frantically on the bank. G-Dub jumped to his feet and scanned the creek bank anxiously. No skinny, naked little boy, just a fairly large...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.